Sydney Gillen, three-time figure Olympia champion, and I'm here with your Open Men's Bodybuilding champion, Tampa Pro, at his pro debut. Go ahead and tell everybody your name, which they already know.
Hunter Labrada, and just won the Tampa Pro, apparently, right?
Yeah. How does it feel? Pro debut, and you come out with a win.
Oh, man, you know, it's what I trained for. I know you understand that. Yeah. You know, at the end of the day, we work every day to win. If you're not working to win, you shouldn't be working.
Absolutely.
So, you know, for the last 26 weeks, it's been head down, thinking about, you know, beating whoever I need to beat and coming in at my best. Felt like I had a lot to prove this year. Yeah. You know, it'd been 2 years since I competed. Mm-hmm. Came off winning nationals, had a shoulder surgery. Mm-hmm. And, you know, people, you know, weren't really sure what I was going to do. I'll be the first one to say I wasn't the most convincing nationals winner. But, you know, got healthy, and I was a good 25 pounds heavier according to the stage weight, and significantly leaner today. So then I was at nationals, so whole new bodybuilder.
How'd you work your way through that injury? How severe was it?
So
what was your mindset coming from?
For nationals, my bicep tendon was almost completely torn in half up here. So we got an MRI. It didn't look that bad. It needed to be fixed. But we're like, okay, let's do nationals.
Okay.
After I got it fixed at nationals, the surgeon, when I woke up, he was like, if I would have presented like it did on the MRI, I would have told you don't go to the gym the next day, and we would have done surgery. So it was torn up, needed fixed, got fixed. It was 6 months down for that. When we got back in the gym, I was 230 and soft. Mm-hmm. 6 months back up to 275, mm-hmm. another 5 months to really improve that body composition. Mm-hmm. And we started prep it. 272, and I woke up this morning at 251. So, you know, 19 pounds the whole time on a guy my size ain't bad. So,
I will completely
agree. Everything came together beautifully. And, you know, my big thing is win the day, is my saying. And, you know, with this year, it very much so was one of those got to focus on winning the individual day, because you don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. You know, my shows got pushed back 3 times.
Yeah. And which shows were you planning to do before Tampa?
I was planning to do New York.
Okay.
Plan was always New York.
Okay.
May 16th.
Okay.
It got pushed. Plan was still to do New York and then Tampa.
Okay.
And then New York got pushed again.
Yeah.
And then it was, okay, we'll do Tampa and then Puerto Rico.
Yeah.
And then Puerto Rico got canceled. And it was like, all right, well, you know, if it's Tampa or nothing, ride or die. So.
And was that mentality that you developed of winning the day, how you kept going through those adversities and keep
pushing?
That's
how I made it through nationals.
Okay.
Because my shoulder hurt so bad. It was like one of those, like, it was just, like, it was unbearable to think about doing it for another week. So I thought about doing it for another day.
Gotcha. And so what got you here, though?
What got me here?
Yeah.
Honestly, how much fun I was having in the gym. I got fixed, and you know, it was I fell in love with training again. That's what I love. This is cool. This is for me to be competitive, though. What I love about what we do is what we do in the gym in the off season.
Absolutely.
And that became fun for me again. And you know, I got to do it every day with my best friend, and you know, we made strides, and we made enough strides to pull this off. So it's back home, probably a week to rest, and then it's back to work to make strides for December.
And what do you think are your points you want to work on? What do you think you want to bring to really just improve and shock everybody in that first Olympia?
For sure. Obviously, you can never be conditioned enough, especially at the Olympia. This is the first time I've been satisfied with how I showed up to prejudging.
Okay.
That being said, satisfied, never happy, though, you know? So it was good enough.
Right.
Not perfect by any means, though. So always improve on the conditioning. And then, you know, I'm not disillusioned to know that, you know, come December, there's going to be, you know, it's a whole different ballgame.
Absolutely.
It's lions and tigers and bears.
Absolutely,
it's
yeah.
the zoo. And, you know, so I definitely need a lot more size from the waist up. I feel like my legs are starting to get there.
Okay.
You know, I feel like my legs will be able to hold their own in December, if I'm being blunt. But from the waist up, it'll be where the work needs to be done. But I'm looking forward to doing it.
And what's it like going through this journey? We all know who your father is. What's it like creating your own name for yourself?
You know, it's really fun. It's really fun. We did it. We're doing it in two different eras. Obviously, he was one of the best in his era. And it's cool to me that his physique is so different from mine.
Yeah.
You know, like, I am his son, but, you know, it's like we joke around. It looks like I ate him.
Yeah.
But, you know, at the same time, it's like we have such similar body parts and similar flow, you know.
Yeah.
So it really is cool to feel like I'm kind of like carrying on the torch, you know, like for the family. But, you know, it's definitely different games, different eras. So,
and do you think his support has really guided you through this process, or were you kind of on your own and he just lent a listening ear?
He's never been one to push me towards bodybuilding.
Okay.
He's never been one to push me towards anything.
Okay.
He has been the one to absolutely support me through heaven and high hell once I decide I want to do something, though.
Yeah.
You know, it was hockey, and then it was football, and now it's bodybuilding, and he's always been there and supported me, you know, like just to the max in any way possible. But, you know, bodybuilding was never pushed on me.
Okay.
You know, I pushed that on myself because, you know, to be blunt, I want to be the best in the world at what I do. And, I feel like I was born to be the best in the world at bodybuilding. So
I love that mentality.
Keep on doing it.
Yep. So we're going to see him in December. Anybody you want to thank before we sign out?
Yeah, for sure. I want to thank my mom and my dad. You know, they've supported me, obviously, since I've been born, but they've always been there for me in every capacity and role. I really want to thank my best friend and training partner, Brian Trianello. We started training together 5 years ago. We actually met backstage at a show. So for all you guys out there, don't be standoffish with your competitors, because it could be your next best friend and training partner. He's actually here. His baby's due in 3 days. His wife's having a C-section, so... both of them. Lauren, shout out to you two for letting me borrow him this close to such a big family event. I love y'all for that. And then my brothers for being here. My coach, Andrew, you know, we've really put together something special, you know, with a Junior USA's win, a Nationals win, and now a pro debut win, and now my rookie Olympia. So, you know, hats off to you, Ninja. We did it again. Can't wait to talk to you after this, man. And, you know, at the end of the day, I have to give glory to God. You know, without him, none of this is possible. You know, I feel like the most blessed man in the world to be able to say I do what I love with who I love. And that's what I do. So I feel very blessed to be able to say that. And I feel very blessed to be able to say I'll be on the Olympia stage in December.
Love to hear. You hear from Hunter himself. Hunter Labrada, Sydney Gillen, and we're out. NPC News Online.